Where is the slick PR campaign encouraging absent parents to take some responsibility for their children? I do not believe in nationalising children. Instead, we need to get back to the idea of taking responsibility.
And whilst I am a huge admirer of the incredible work teachers do, they are sadly being cajoled by barren bosses in unions like the Not Education Union, led by Bolshevik Balsen and Commie Courtney, with their Labour mates to force teachers out of the classroom and make sure that kids continue to suffer. What can we do to make sure pupils will not be victims any further?
Secondly, in the case of retained EU rights, why are those people who have existing rights of action only able to get this strange concession that for 3 months they might be able to pursue those rights? Otherwise, retrospectively, they will lose them if solicitors don't act quickly enough or they don't realise in time they might have an action.
Everyone will recall the images from last summer of monuments being dragged into rivers and the statue of our greatest ever Prime Minister, Winston Churchill, being vandalised by hooligans. I know that my right honourable friend will share my delight that the government are introducing new legal safeguards to avoid pandering to the whims of the woke left in censoring our proud history. Will he therefore look to hold a debate in government time on how we can look to further protect our history and our heritage from those who wish to revise our past and tear down statues and monuments?
In relation to delivery of Labour, Dover and Deal, under those many years of a Labour government, saw its health service absolutely decimated, service by service. What's happened under the Conservative government? Let me tell you, there has been a new hospital built for Dover. There has been the first dementia village in the country built for Dover and Deal. There is the first one of the first 40 diagnostic COVID hubs that's been delivered for Dover and Deal, and a new GP training centre delivered for East Kent. Of course, there is more to do. There is more to do on health. We have the plan.
Order. Order. Interventions must be brief by definition. Where's Streeting?
When I hear words like sourcing housing and getting extra hotel spaces for illegal immigrants, it leaves a bitter taste in my throat. And I tell you what, I've got 5,000 people in Ashfield want to secure council housing and they cannot get one, and yet we're here debating this nonsense once again. When are we going to stop blaming the French, the ECHR, the lefty lawyers? The blame lies in this place right now. When are we going to grow a backbone and do the right thing and send them straight back the same day?
Workforce plan, which we set up. And thirdly, we have already set out our electives recovery plan. You saw, Mr. Speaker, will have seen over the summer that those longest waits of over 2 years were largely cleared. And from the front bench, they chunter as to how it's going. Well, if you look at how that is going compared to the Labour government's 2 year. England have been working on the workforce plan.
I won't repeat the arguments on any of them at any length at all, because I addressed some of them in committee and they've been very well put today. But I'm astonished that we've got to report without actually having a very, as yet, adequate response to any of them.
Let's dispel some of the myths around this issue that we hear from the opposition, lefty lawyers and celebrity do-gooders. Many of the people entering this country in small boats are not genuine asylum seekers. If their lives were truly in danger, they would have claimed sanctuary in the first safe country they arrived in. Instead, these people have travelled through many safe European nations to try to come to the UK. They are invariably single young men and increasingly from nations such as Albania. They are not coming here for sanctuary, but as illegal economic migrants. Our public services are already creaking under enormous pressure, and we simply can't accept hundreds of millions of people who would no doubt look to come here for a better life. I am afraid this country is nearly full.
The way people to have a vaccine is, of course, to line up the entire government and its ministers and their loved ones and let them take it first, and then get all the lovies, the icons of popular culture, out on the airwaves singing its praises. To have any kind of suggestion of coercion absolutely feeds the conspiracy theory that we are being cowed and our liberties being taken away.
Extremely grateful to him for giving way. Will he agree with me that it's not enough for the government merely to refrain from coercing people? The government's also got to pay attention to implicit coercion. That is, if the government turns a blind eye to allowing businesses like airlines and restaurants to refuse to let people in unless they've had the vaccination, the government's got to decide whether it's willing to allow people to discriminate on that basis.
Discrimination. It would be vaccinationism, which we must, of course, resist.
Many of them have taken the chance, there are economic migrants who are taking a chance by crossing the English Channel. Can I ask the Home Secretary, if people come here illegally, why can't we just deport them?
They're then leaving France, which is a safe country, and coming to the UK across the Channel. And then when they get this accommodation, we've got the opposition parties saying the accommodation is not good enough for them. Yeah. Well, does the Home Secretary agree with me that if the accommodation is not good enough for them, they can get on a dinghy and go straight back to France?
Yeah. And again, Stoke-on-Trent, which currently houses over 800, is being asked to carry the burden with an attempt to try and place more in the North Stafford Hotel. Will my right honourable friend immediately stop this abuse of Stoke-on-Trent and instead put illegal economic migrants in places with open border and free movement supporters, such as the Shadow Immigration Minister?
Less than a year ago, I celebrated what I thought was the election of a sceptical and liberal Conservative administration. And now I'm left wondering if the Prime Minister hasn't been abducted by Dr. Strangelove and reprogrammed by the sage over to the dark side. The purpose of politicians is to impose a measure of proportion, a sense of proportion on science, and not to be enthralled to it. Now, I will make myself very unpopular, but I believe that the appearance of the chiefs last week should have been a sacking offence. When they presented that graph, oh, with the caveat that it wasn't a prediction, but nevertheless, it was clear that they presented it as a plausible scenario, with its 50,000 cases per day by mid-October, based on the doubling of infections by the week. Not once, not on one day since March, have there been infections on that day that were double that of the day of the week preceding. Not once. Where did this doubling come from? What was their purpose in presenting such a graph? It was the purpose of the fat boy in Pickwick Papers. I wants to make your flesh creep. It was Project Fear. It was an attempt to terrify the British people, as if they haven't been terrified enough.